Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Out of the Park Baseball 23 with the Washington Nationals. We are into year, what, six, seven, eight? I don't know. Let's look. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. We're into our eighth year. We've gotten better five straight seasons, 64 wins, 74 wins, 85, 90, and 97. And we are on pace at 19 and 12 through April to have our best year yet. So, made the playoffs three straight seasons. Things are looking up for the Nats. We are in first place. We're 3.5 games clear of the Braves. Second in runs scored, fourth in runs against. Sort of all coming together here. CJ Abrams hurt once again. It's becoming an issue. I mean, they're minor injuries, but he only played 100 games last year. And he's going to play 120 this year if he stays healthy the rest of the year. But, I mean, his contract is up, so it's something we're going to have to think about. That number's actually coming down a little bit, too. It was 24, 25, something like that, so we'll see what happens. I'm certainly not giving him 7 years or whatever it is he's asking for, but we will see. We will see. Offensively, Michael Mullinax, Luis Robert really carrying us, both hitting over 300 with more than 20 runs knocked in. Juan Villalobos, our acquisition from Atlanta, has gotten off to a hot start. Five homers, 17 RBIs, a 140 OPS plus, on pace for 26 home runs and playing pretty good third base. So far, so good there. From a pitching perspective, Burns and Baz have been just lights out, 7-2 with an ERA close to 2 between the two of them. Cavalli hasn't been good, and I actually have him in a trade package that I've got out there right now. We'll see if it's going to be approved, but or accepted, I guess. But he hasn't been good. His ratings have dropped, and his contract is up at the end of the season. So one way or another, Cade Cavalli will likely not be on the team next season. Chase Shores has gotten off to a pretty good start in his six starts, 27 strikeouts in 27 innings. And Todd Niebe is not pitching. I mean, he's just not getting deep into games. I mean, he hasn't pitched more than 4 2/3 innings yet. So we may need to come up with something to do at the back end of the rotation, just with the depth into which we're getting into these games. Our bullpen hasn't been particularly good. It's been okay, seventh. But given the way it's been the last couple of years, it hasn't been terrific. So we'll see how it goes there. Davis Crane, 9 home runs on pace for 47 home runs. Again, low batting average, which is a bit of a surprise given the 60 contact, but I figured he wouldn't strike out quite that much with the 70 avoid K. I figured the walk to strikeout ratio would be a little bit better than this given his eye and his discipline. Let's get a scouting report. But you know, we'll see. We will see. He was league average last year with the bat. He was better than that with Atlanta. So anyway, we are 19 and 12. Things are looking pretty good. We get Abrams back in a couple of weeks. We start the month of May with 3 games on the road against Austin, followed by a 7-game homestand, 5-4 loss, 5-4 win in 10 innings. We score in the top of the 10th. Villalobos with a 3-run homer. Crane with a home run. Cavalli pitches well. Kerr gives up a couple. Actually, it looks like Veras gave up the runs. Inherited runners. Ray Kerr hasn't been good this year, which is kind of disappointing because we need him. Hopefully, he can turn it around. Brule and Munoz pitched the last couple innings. So we take one. We split the first 2 games in Austin. Third game is a 9-3 win. All right, so we get a no way here, but we might be able to work on it. So I'll show you the trade in a second. Again, it was with Atlanta, which I know is fairly unrealistic, but they had the players that I wanted. So we will see how it goes. 2 hits, 5 RBIs for Drew Romo. 3 hits for Villalobos. Cruz and Robert each homer. Niebe goes, there's the first inning, first game where he's gone 5, and we win 9-3. So that trade would have been Cade Cavalli, Yoan Moncada, who we have in the minor leagues, and Miller Green for Mitch Spence, Umberto Delgado, and Jackson Wentworth. It started with Mitch Spence because of the extreme ground ball, 70 movement. He's making the league minimum right now. He'll be able to replace somebody that we have on the big league roster next year. Umberto Delgado is just a, good, pretty good defensive, high speed, high loyalty, work ethic, captain type player. And this is the one that sort of is triggering it. Like, they're not telling me no. So that tells me that I can get Wentworth somehow. I just have been trying to sort out how to do it. See, it says just offer us a little bit more. So I'm trying to figure out what that little more is. I don't know what they consider a little more. So that's kind of where I am here trying to sort this out. Bascruz Romo. I mean, I'll probably make the deal. If I take Wentworth out, I can get Spence and Delgado for like Moncada, I think, which I'm totally fine with. But I want to. I would like to be able to pick up Wentworth. He's a starter. OSA likes him just as much as we do. Obviously, his stuff won't be quite as good as a starting pitcher, but four good pitches, decent stamina. I think he'll be pretty good. Yeah, so Jackson Wentworth. I would love to pick him up. I don't know that it's going to be possible. I mean, I believe that it is just based off of this. I just don't know what the right, like, I don't know what triggers it. I don't know what makes them say that's enough. Or, you get that, you kind of get to that next level of, submit it and we'll let you know kind of thing. I just don't know what that answer is. So if I remove Wentworth, I can remove him and I should be able to. Oh, they. I mean, if I have to. I can't. Oh, right. I can't. I mean, I feel like this is an okay deal even with just Cavalli. Because I think they do it just for Cavalli. No, they want Moncada in there as well. Like, I don't care. You can have Yoan Moncada. I mean, it's fine. The problem is I don't get that. I mean, I guess Mitch Spence could be a starter. Let's hold off and see what the scouting report is on him. I mean, Mitch Spence probably would be as good a starter as Cavalli. I mean, he's got the same stamina, he's got better movement. So let's just see what the scouting report comes back on for Mitch Spence, and we will go from there. All right. So we got four games now at home against Houston. Three games at home against Houston. We lose the first one. We win 11-3. Nicky Lopez, 3-for-4. McDaniel is hitting the ball pretty well as a rookie. 17-for-66, couple of home runs. Robert with a three-run homer. Corbin Burns picks up his fourth victory of the year. And I'm waiting to see if. Ooh, Battenfield. We traded him to Los Angeles, and now he's out for 12 months. That's no good. Well, no good for them anyway. All right, game three. Three against Houston, four against Milwaukee at home. 1-0. So we put up 11 runs, and then we put up one run. Run knocked in by Crow Armstrong, Shane Baz, 6 2/3, Wandas and Charles. So we walked it off in the 11th. Wandas and Charles gets the win. Now four at home against the Brewers. Four two wins. So the Diamondbacks want to make us a trade off for Andre Romero and Joe Roberts for Zach McKinstry and Pat. You can't have Pat Davis. Like, these guys are no good. I'm not against trading Zach McKinstry, but like, I'm not giving up Pat Davis for him. So we went 4-2. Villalobos drives in three. Cruz drives in a run. Dylan Cruz average up to 219. He was hitting like a buck 50, like 3 weeks into the season. Cavalli pitches well. So I want to wait until we get that scouting report back on Mitch Spence. Game two against the Brewers. Another win. Three hits for Mullinax. Robert goes 3-for-3 with three runs scored. Cruz has a couple hits. Villalobos has a triple. Hassel hits his eighth home run of the year. Two hits for Crane. He's got 10 home runs and 15 runs knocked in. Nebe goes 4 1/3. Hill cleans up after him, gets the win. Third game of the series now against Milwaukee. Nine-eight victory. We walk it off. So they scored the game tying run in the top of the ninth. We win it in the bottom of the ninth. Two hits, three RBIs for Cruz and Romo. Average for Drew's a little light this year. That's not Drew. That's the wrong guy. Yeah, average of 244. He's still on pace for 5 WAR, 32 home runs. So can't complain there. We'll take a look at some of the guys that we traded: Juan Soto and K-Bear Ruiz and that sort of thing. But all in all, another good game. Chase Shores gives up 4 in 3 innings. Munoz blows the save, picks up the win. Let's look at Juan Soto. Where is he now? Colorado, really? 142 OPS on base for a 4.7 WAR. What's his contract look like? 5 years, 125 million. You see, I probably wouldn't have given him that. I mean, if he stays healthy, he's worth it. But I don't know that I'm giving that to him to play 116 games last year. He played 159 the year before that, but 116 games last year. So I don't know. Anyway, he's playing at Colorado now. And K-Bear. Also in Colorado. Buck 94. Oof. With a 579 OPS. So I think we made a couple of smart deals there. Younger and cheaper. Final game at home against Milwaukee as we look for the sweep and 6 in a row. And we get it. CJ Abrams is back. So Ty Pete can go to the minors. Abrams will come up and he will go back into the lineup at shortstop. We'll move him up in the lineup here in a minute. Abrams will come in at shortstop. Move him there. Move him up. Move him there. Move him up. And Nicky Lopez. Every sixth game, I guess. Nicky Lopez every eighth game against lefties. So Lewis, Villalobos. Yeah, these guys are all going to need days off. But right now, they're all tired because we were a man down. Ty Pete wasn't playing. So we went 4-3. That's a good sweep. Corbin Burns, 5-1, strikes out 10. 4-4 for Royce Lewis, who's starting to hit. That being said, I don't think I'm picking up his option. It's $12.6 million option. He's still a decent fielder. And, we're going to get sidetracked here because you guys know how I do this. But if we can shave Royce Lewis's 12.6, Pete Crow Armstrong's 5.2 and Andre Munoz's 8 and replace those guys with, 80% of the production for 10% of the cost, all of a sudden we just cleared up $26 million, which is more than enough to re-sign Abrams. It's enough to re-sign Charles if we want to, and to potentially make a move for one of those free agents that's available. So have some decisions to make in the offseason, but that's a long way away. So three games in Colorado now. We've won 6 in a row. I think Colorado's pretty good right now in this save. We win 8-6, 21-17. Yeah, they're not bad. 28-14 through 42 games for us. Robert, Hassel homers, it sounds like Hasselhoff. Hassel homers, Cruz homers, Crane homers. Crane 1-for-2 with 3 runs scored. Baz goes 3, gives up 5, but our bullpen is better than their bullpen. Game 2. Another win. Wow, we are playing some good baseball right now. Romo 3-for-4 with a home run and 2 doubles. CJ Abrams goes 3-for-5 with 3 runs knocked in. Hits his first home run of the year. Crane drives in a couple. Abrams, when he's healthy, is such an impact player. 780 OPS, 110 OPS plus, but he's so good defensively. He's great on the base paths. When he's healthy, he's fantastic for us. It was really exactly what we needed, I think. Game 3 in Colorado. A tough road trip, Colorado and San Francisco. Another win, 10-9. So they scored 4 in the bottom of the 8th to tie it off of Figueroa, who continues to not pitch well. Kerr and Munoz pitch 2 shutout innings. Villalobos homers twice. Crane, Robert, McDaniel. Luis Robert's been so good. Like, I talk about trading him because of his contract, but he's on pace to put up 8 WAR this season. So You know, I will keep talking about trading him, and then hopefully he keeps hitting like this. All right, so now we got three on the road against the Giants before coming home. There's our first loss in a week and a half. 5-3, 17-inning game. CJ Abrams, 2-for-7. Cruz, need a home run. Yeah, hit a home run in the 17th. Two RBIs for Romo. Burns goes 5 2/3, and then our bullpen goes 11 1/3 shutout. That's nice. I'll take that. And the final game of the series in San Francisco before a much needed day off. We haven't had a day off in like 3 weeks. Oh, so we went 5-3 and 17, and we get shut out in the other two games. So we're 9 games up in the National League East. Wow. Okay. Second run scored, sixth in runs against. Our bullpen still hasn't been good, so maybe that's an area of opportunity come. Oh, that's what I wanted to look at the wanted to see if we got a scouting report on. No, we didn't. And I already forgot his name, so let's just go to Atlanta. Mitch Spence. It's still just high. Oh, he's injured. Crap. All right. Well, that's fine. Trade block. What do we got on the trade block? I think we're fine offensively. Again, it's pitching. Onishko, we can bring him back. Luis Siga, making 6.9. And if you retain. Really? I got nobody who can make this work? Find that hard to believe. Find that hard to believe. Interesting. What if I gave you one of, what if I gave you Munoz? Tampa Bay can't afford that. All right, well, we'll see. We're not there yet. It's only May. I don't think we need to be making any drastic decisions yet. It's still early. 3 games against Atlanta. 3-0 win. Two hits, two RB or two hits and an RBI for Hassel and Robert. Cavalli. I talk about trading him, and all of a sudden he starts pitching well. So, you know, still don't think we're gonna re-sign him, but you know, maybe we hang on to him if he continues to pitch like this. Again, plenty of time. 10-4 win. Mullinax drives in three. Cruz has 3 hits, has that average up to 235. Abrams up to 287. Nicky Lopez, 3 hits, has 3 doubles. Meaby, Hill, and Bennett each go three. Hill is 7-0 out of the bullpen this year for us. And the final game of the series against the Braves, team we struggled mightily with last season. And we sweep them out of Washington 7-3. 3 hits and an RBI for Drew. Cruz has 2 hits. Abrams and Robert each driving a couple. Cruz, Robert, Romo, all homer. Shore strikes out 10 in 4 2/3. Our bullpen does their bullpen things. And now we've got Austin for three. Another win, 12-3. Top of the order doing it again. Mullinax, Robert, Abrams, Cruz, Crane, all with multi-hit games. Romo has 2 hits. Mullinax, Crane homers twice. Cruz and Abrams. Burns 6-1, 11 strikeouts. All right, game two against Austin. 3-2 win in extras, a walk-off victory. 3-for-4 for Mullinax, who's really turned the corner about midway through last season. 3 hits for Abrams, has that average up over 300. Baz strikes out 10 in 5 1/3. Munoz gets the win. We look for the sweep of Austin now. And we don't get it, and we lose Royce Lewis for 1 to 2 weeks. All right. And I thought I saw, yeah, everyone's hurt. Everyone's hurt. Pete is out for 2 weeks. Errol Vera is out for 2 days. can't really play those positions though. So who do we have? I mean, Nicky Lopez becomes the starter. So I guess it's probably Vera just for now. Yeah, I guess. So put Nicky Lopez in at second. It's only a week. I mean, he's out for 2 days, so we'll just, when the starters get tired, Vera can come in and play for them at that position. It's fine. He can't do that much damage in a 10-day window, I don't think. All right, so we lose. That's fine. That's only our one, two, three, four, fifth loss of the month. But now we go back out west, Los Angeles and San Diego, to finish the month of May. Seven games in California. 7-5 victory. Two in the ninth, two in the tenth. Love it. McDaniel has a couple of hits. Villalobos and Cruz each homer. Romo's got that average up to almost 300 already. So, yeah, he's turned it around here this month. Game two against the Dodgers. 4-2 loss. Looking for 4-3 on this trip. We can take a look at that. Three runs in the first. Yeah, if we go 4-3 on the West Coast road trip, I'm okay with that. Yeah, Crow Armstrong isn't hitting. As much as I like having him on the team because of his defense, for that kind of money, we can use that money elsewhere. Even just to reinvest into scouting and development. 7-1 for Corbin Burns, game four against the Dodgers, as we look to take three out of four. Nope, split the series. So we want two out of three in San Diego. That's what we're aiming for here. Nope. 2-3 so far on the trip. Here's 3-3. Dylan Cruz, a couple of solo home runs. Nieby goes four, but Hill picks up his eighth win. And if we win this game, we end the month of May 40-20, which would be pretty solid. And we do. So we go 4-3 on the trip, which is what I wanted. Villalobos 2-for-5, 4 RBIs. Cruz 2-for-4, 3 RBIs. Abrams has 3 hits. Romo has 2 hits. Vera comes in and has 2 hits. Cruz, Romo, Villalobos with 2, Crane with his 17th. Shores picks up the victory. Kerr, Figueroa, and Brule. Let's sim the last day of the month. All right, so we are 40-20 at the end of May. I will take that. So Nieby gets a little, stuff gets a little worse, everything else gets better. Kerr gets better, Vera gets better, McDaniel gets better. Yes, offensive ratings. We got to find a spot for first base. We're wasting him at first base with his ratings. He really should be probably in left field, but we'll figure it out. Volpato gets a little worse. Barclay gets a little better. Bat's starting to come around. We're gonna need him at second base sooner rather than later. So hopefully he can get a bump here the rest of this season. Swain, who was our first pick last year. Gets a little worse. Longoria, who was one of our first international guys, continues to struggle. Let's call him up and see if bumping him up a level will help him. Barnett. A lot of negatives in there, man. That's disappointing. Cardenas. He's not quite ready to be called up yet. All right. So Juan Soto is your batter of the month in the National League, in the American League. Torkelson, pitcher of the month in the AL. Dennis Colaran, Savino is your pitcher of the month in the NL. Rookie of the month in the AL, Brock Thompson. And Henry in the National League. So that's going to do it for May. You guys know how this works. I'm going to go ahead and sim June. And when we come back, it will be July 1st. So I will talk to you guys on 7-1. I'll be back in a minute. Hey guys, we're back. It's July 1st. And we are running away and hiding with the National League East this year. We have a 15-game lead on the Atlanta Braves. We have the best record in baseball. It's the first time we can say that on July 1st, 55 and 31. It was a weird month. We were really bad at the beginning of the month and really good at the end of the month. So you look at our schedule, we lost three, four, five, six, 7 out of 9 here in this stretch. And then we won immediately won like 10 in a row, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, 9 in a row. So we lost 7 out of 9, then won 9 straight. So it was a really weird season, but we ended up 15 and 11, 55 and 31 for the month, second in runs scored. Fourth in runs against, bullpen has gotten much better. I knew we probably didn't need to make a change there. I don't know that there's a whole lot we need to add to this team, truth be told. We have one of the best offenses, one of the best pitching staffs. We don't have a huge minor league system to speak of. Chuck Bland is probably our best offensive prospect. Chris Barkley is our best, probably defensive prospect. And then pitching wise, who the hell knows? Jeff Swain, maybe. He was our number one pick a year ago, but isn't all that great. So, yeah, we really haven't been developing. I mean, we did develop Mullinax, which is nice, but that's really been it from an offensive perspective. We just aren't developing offensive talent. Well, Dylan Cruz too. I take that back. Dylan Cruz has been a nice piece for us. So we've developed a couple of bats. So yeah, I don't think there's a whole lot we need to do, but we'll see. I would like to. I'd like to keep Joey Estes around. I don't like his. I mean, I shouldn't say I don't like. He's only making $2.5 million, so it's not unreasonable. But it's money that's in the minor leagues, which is a waste right now. But big picture, it may not be because I think ultimately Nebe's spot is probably in the bullpen. He's only thrown 66 innings and 16 starts this season. He's averaging about 4 innings a start. So I mean, he hasn't been bad, 2.6 WAR, but I think he's probably better served in the bullpen. So we will likely need a starter at some point, but that's not a problem for right now. All right, let's take a shot in the dark with a international guy. I mean, I think the answer is Molina, and see if he wants to come to play for us, and we'll just go from there. So I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna sim up to the draft, and then I'm gonna take another one more quick break. So you do have do this video in pieces like I always do, and I've got some stuff I gotta take care of this afternoon. Hopefully, I can come back and finish the recording this evening. So we win 9-1. Dylan Cruz and Romo each have 3 RBIs. Shane Baz goes 6 1/3, easy victory. Three on no, 7 on the road now, leading into the All-Star break and the draft. 8-4 loss. Yeah, Molina signed with the White Sox. I don't know that there's anybody else here that I want to throw money at. I've just gotten burned so much with some of these guys that I think I'm going to take a year off from international amateurs, honestly, and just store that money and just not use it. I think that's the plan. Game two against the Mets. Keep that $5 million for free agents, sort of dump it back into scouting and development. So that's 2 losses in a row. And this is how last month started out, too. 3 losses in a row. Thankfully, we have a huge lead. There we go. 6-0 win. 2 hits for Romo, Lewis, McDaniel. McDaniel homers. Corbin Burns, 10 and 2. He's having a Cy Young style season. 10-2 win. 5 RBIs for Royce Lewis. I talk about not picking up his option, and then you look up and he's put up a 4-win season. So, like, I don't know what we're going to do. We will see. Villalobos having a good year. 26 home runs has already almost matched his season total from a year ago. I mean, he's on pace to put a 5.5 WAR for the league minimum. I mean, like, that's how you win World Series, right? Baz is 7-6. Third game against Pittsburgh. We're 3-3 now this month. Lose a game in 18 innings. They want to send us Solumeto for Zion. No, I'm not going to do that. All-Star games. Corbin Burns. Wandason Charles. Drew Romo. Villalobos. Luis Robert. So it's five. Five All-Stars? I'll take it. I can't imagine we're going to have anybody in the prospect game. our prospects are not particularly good. Hernandez is down in rookie ball right now. He's got a shot. I mean, if it stays, if his ratings stay that way, be a good center fielder, but I don't know if that's going to happen. Our final game of the series against Pittsburgh is a win. We lose Drew Romo for 2 weeks. That's not ideal. Mullinax hits a home run. Robertas, three hits. Hassel, he's only hitting 238. He's fragile now. Maybe that's a contract we look to move, and we end up putting McDaniel out in left. I mean, as a left fielder, I feel like he would be pretty good. Who else is hurt? I thought I saw another name that was hurt. Yeah, Figueroa diagnosis pending. All right, so who do we have? So we bring up Banfield, right? Okay, so Romo goes on the injured list. We bring up Banfield. Go to the lineup. Susak is going to be our starting catcher against both lefties and righties. We will put Banfield in as when the starter gets tired. All right, so we won this game 9-5. We already looked at this box score. We got 100 emails. Nothing I need to look at though. All right, so we are 59-35. Let's sim up to the draft. 13 and a half games ahead of the Braves, 14 ahead of the Mets. Look at Davis Crane, 29 home runs already, batting out of the number 8 hole. On pace for 50. Offense looking sharp. And we lose Figueroa for the year. That's a little concerning, but we will persevere. So who comes up? Miles Jansen, ground ball pitcher, 3-8, 3.95. Joey Estes, normal, 8-3. He was really good out of the bullpen last year, though. So let's go Estes. Make him a middle reliever. And Zach Bennett can move into a. No, he can stay right where he is. And I think Hill becomes. Yeah, I think Hill becomes the middle reliever. Estes becomes the long reliever. And we do that. And put him in there as a backup setup guy too. All right. So let's start the draft, I guess. I got a few more minutes here before I gotta bounce for a bit, but let's start the draft. That's not where I wanted to go. We're picking 29th. They think we are going to take Ernesto Grijalva. Grijalva, Ernesto Grijalva. I mean, he's a decent bat, but that's it. He doesn't have a position, so we'll see. All right, let's just go up to our pick and see what we see. Phil Sims. Fragile, impossible. Dave Bergen. I think this is our guy. We'll see what else is available. I like him, like the power, like the gap power, but again, I don't want to take a first baseman in the first round. I got burned doing that previously. Tim Applegate looks pretty good. Briseño looks pretty good. Some good names in this draft. Andy Fox. I wish he was there in the second round. I'd love to take him in the second round. I don't think he's going to be, though. Arturo Moreno. Bergen. Right now, it's Bergen is my pick. He can play center field. A decent bat. The eye and discipline isn't great, but they think we should take Luis Santa Cruz, the first baseman. Again, I mean, I love, dig the power, but I don't really need it. John Hubbard, an 18-year-old ground ball pitcher. All right. You know what, guys? I'm going to pause and I'm going to think about where I want to go with this pick. I like John Hubbard. I also like Dave Bergen. And then, sort of, the under the radar pick is Andy Fox. He's more developed. I'm hoping one of those three guys falls to the second round, but I'm going to pause and we're going to finish the draft in just a minute, guys. Well, for you, it'll be for a minute. For me, it'll be a few hours, but we'll finish it either way. Be right back. All right, guys, we're back. As I said, it's about a couple hours later. And I think the decision is Dave Bergen. He's 21 years old. He's more developed, so he'll be able to help us sooner. He's a good defensive outfielder, has enough speed. I think the bat's good enough. He may not be the best bat. I think there are a couple bats in here that are better. Like if Phil Simms is there as an impossible guy, like in the third round or something, I may take a run at him. But I think he's the best all-around player here. And my hope is that Andy Fox falls to the second round. If Fox falls to the second round, he's my pick. So we're going to take Dave Bergen with our top pick. Saves us some money as well. And we'll keep our fingers crossed that Andy Fox is there in the next round. He is not. That is unfortunate. Pitching wise, we still have John Hubbard is available. Low, high greed, low loyalty, low leader. Flash the potential to be a top of the rotation starter. I kind of like him as our second round pick, or Danny Ramos maybe. Yeah, I kind of like Danny Ramos. Four good pitches, elite control, fantastic stamina. I think we go Danny Ramos in the second round. Hubbard is still there in the third. Is that batter there? He is. Do we take a shot at Phil Simms here in the third round? Arturo Moreno, he's impossible as well. Still some decent bats in the draft here. I kind of want to see if we can push Simms back to the fourth with Hubbard still there. OSA doesn't like him quite as much, but even at 50, 50, 55 with 65 pitches as a ground ball pitcher, I think so. And then hopefully that first baseman is still there and we can take him. He is. We're going to take Phil Simms and see what he wants in the fourth round. Chris Bowman. Chris Ruggieri looks okay. Yeah, we started. I don't want to say we hit a wall because I think we just got four really good players, but yeah, Marrero looks pretty good, but picking two impossible guys doesn't make a whole lot of sense. So let's look at all players. Jonathan Polk. He's probably what, a third baseman? At least with those defensive ratings, but the offensive ratings are just weird. And not seeing anything that is. Jamie Carr? Good defensive, very good defensively, good speed. Yeah, I'll take Jamie Carr. Let's look at individual pitch potential. Wow, Harlan Noel. 18 years old, high adapt. Yeah, I'm going to take him. 70 stuff, 40 movement, 30 control, 370 plus level pitches. I'm going to take him and hope that he develops. My guess is he doesn't, but we will try anyway. Mike Haas. Oh, excuse me. Nope. Chris Schmidt. Out of Boston. Went to high school in Vegas. Interesting. He's actually not terrible, really. 60 stuff, 35 movement and control. If one of those gets a bump, I don't know if this changeup will ever develop, but with it being a 75, it's a possibility. I don't think I need to take him just yet, though. All right, what do we got? Ben Woods. Randy Thornton, 70 ability, low work ethic. I don't like that out of a catcher. Oh, these catchers are kind of good ratings, but their personalities are pretty garbage. Nehemiah Dibbles. That's a great name. I'm going to take him. Just for the memes, as they say. Infield range. Let's get to our next pick. Chris Bostic, 22 years old, out of Waltham. Went to Army. I like him. Bat looks okay. Good outfield arm. Probably a right fielder more than anything else, but. Omari Carthan. Carthon. Chris Wheaton. Meh. It's weird how he's got better outfield ratings than infield ratings, but he's listed as a second baseman. Bobby Pipes. That's just a fantastic name. We're going to take some Bobby Pipes. Wow, Chris Dechany. We're going to take him as well. Pretty elite defensively. I think that's enough. That's 10 rounds. Let the AI do what the AI do. Let's go ahead and negotiate. Let's offer here and here. Let's offer contracts to all these guys because their demand is higher than the slot. And then we'll go back and we'll look at our impossible guy. Yeah, we have $8 million. So we probably aren't signing him. Significantly above 8.8. We only have 7.3. Yeah. I mean, we'll offer him 7.3. He's not going to take it, but we'll offer it to him. All right. So, do we need to do anything? And we're 13 and a half games up. I say we sim ahead a week or so. I mean, let's get like through, I don't know, this Philadelphia series and see where we stand and then sort of figure out if we need to make any moves. We got San Diego coming up, Tampa, Philadelphia, and then we finish the month with Austin, New York, and Chicago. It's game one at home against the Padres. Not good. Todd Niebi has got a forearm strain, so I think we should probably, not DFA, we should probably put him on the injured list. Let's call up Miles Jansen because he's a ground ball guy. We'll put Estes in the rotation. We'll make Jansen the long reliever, and we will continue to sim. And we win 6-5, and we lose Cavalli for 7 weeks. That's starting to become an issue. Crane with a couple of hits. He's got 31 home runs now. Cavalli goes 4 1/3 before getting hurt. Omar Woodward, I think, is about ready. Let's give him a call up. Let's stick him right in the rotation, I think. 50, 55, 50, ground ball pitcher. Couple of good pitches. I mean, he's 27, so it's now or nothing for him. So let's see if we can get a few years out of him. Game three at home against the Padres. Another win, 8-7. We walk it off in the bottom of the ninth. Dylan Cruz, a couple of hits, couple RBIs. Villalobos with a couple of runs knocked in. Cruz homers. Chase Shores gives up 5-3. He hasn't been all that good, frankly. And he's probably I think we're gonna need another starter in the offseason. These starters with the 40 stamina just aren't working. I think he'll play really well as a reliever, but I think we need another starter. So we might see if we can find one here at the deadline. Now, Drew Romo is out for a little bit longer. That's not ideal. Injuries starting to pile up a little bit here as we get through July, as OOTP tends to do. So we score 4 runs in the last 3 innings to win this one. Royce Lewis up to almost 300. Crane hits his 32nd home run of the year. Burns goes 5, gives up 3. Veras gets the win. Munoz with the save. Two against Tampa. Yeah, we'll get through Philadelphia. We win again, so that's 4 straight victories. Abrams 2 for 4, 3 runs knocked in. Lewis 1 for 3, 2 runs knocked in. Estes 7 1/3, 1 run, 11 strikeouts. Well, there you go. We'll see what's available in on the trade block once we get through this series against Philly. 5-1 wins. So that's five straight now. Cruz with a two-run homer. Royce Lewis homers for a third straight game. Shane Baz, seven shutout innings. That's awesome. Game two. I am recording, right? I am, yes. 6-2 loss and the final game on the road here against Philly. It's a 7-2 victory. So looking pretty sharp. 65 and 37 through 102 games. Robert Hassel, 3 for 4. Cruz, 2 for 5, 3 RBIs. Lewis, 3 more hits. Shores goes 5. All right. So got a couple options here. We can either go for something big. Like, I would love to keep Hassel, but he is fragile. He's 27. His contract is 4 more years after this at $56-ish million. So 4 years, $56-ish million for somebody who's basically a two-war player. We could stick McDaniel in left field. Offense would be fine. We would suffer a little bit defensively because Hassel 55, 65, 60. McDaniel 50, 60, 65. So we'd suffer a little bit in left field, but maybe we can add a starting pitcher this way. Not a great starting pitcher. Extreme fly ball. That's not great. And he signed to a long-term deal as well. Okay, so there's something there. So if we look at the trade block, what do we got for pitchers? Workman, any starters? Max Fried is hurt. Hunter Green, $17 million. No player that makes that work. Yeah, 'cause I don't have, I mean, I don't have much money left, so they would have to retain. I find it hard to believe that I don't have anybody that will make that work. Grayson Rodriguez is making $18 million. Bryce Elder. No, I don't want to pay this year and next. Looking for those ground ball starting pitchers. That's what I want. Duran, extreme ground ball making $14 million. Nah, it's not great. Yeah, we don't need any. I mean, there's some pretty elite talent. Like Christian Gonzalez is there. I mean, he's also fragile now though. So, that's big money waiting to burn you. How's Jung Hoo Lee doing this year? He's in Toronto. He's doing all right. Doing all right after two really good years with us. Didn't sign a ridiculous contract. Only 1 year, 5.2. All right. So we need pitching. We need pitching. We need pitching. I want to see something. So let's do this. Let's go here and let's go here and let's just see. Okay. All right. I retain that and you retain this. Really? So if I eat 100% of the contract, you won't give me Hunter Green. That's interesting. All right. So let's go here. Not here. Let's go. Where am I going? Here. Let's try this. Let's just see. 'Cause I mean, I'll back off. Obviously, I can back some of it off. Extreme flyball pitcher in Coors, that's not good. Curdna looks pretty good. 26-year-old, at least arb eligible. His arb number next year is, oof, 9.3 million. I'm good with that. Ooh, I like him. 25-year-old lefty, ground ball pitcher. How much can we back this down? I knew Moncada would have some value. All right. So if I give you $1 million, so we trade Robert Hassel, who has been an above average offensive player, an above average defensive player, but we have his replacement. We have his replacement in Dan McDaniel. The bat's better on McDaniel. The offense is, or the defense is not much worse. If we do something like this, who becomes our leadoff hitter? I guess that's the big question. That's, I guess, the next question. Wow, this guy's really good. Who is our, yeah, see, I like him. I think he's, ooh. Let's see what the scouting report looks like on him before we make that final decision. So if we trade Hassel, McDaniel moves into the starting lineup at left field. Who becomes our leadoff hitter? Is it Mullinax? No, he's only a 325. Is it Lewis? I mean, I guess it becomes, or yeah, Robert's at 352, but that's driven by the batting average. I don't want to make it Abrams. Again, I don't have a huge OBP guy. Not that Hassel's a huge, I mean, he's got a 338. So if I replace his 338 with his 349, we should be fine in theory. So let's see what else we can get in this deal. This also frees up some money for next season because, again, we've got some players that we want to bring back, right? We need to re-sign CJ Abrams. We got a couple people that we need to be bringing back. So what else are they willing to give us? Ryan Fry. Noah Malone. How do I feel about this? How do I feel? I don't feel terrible about it, truth be told. Just looking to see what else I can add. You know how this works. You got to get as much as you possibly can. Joey Cantillo pitching in the minor leagues. I like this because it gives us a little bit more depth. His arb number next year is only two. That's fine. I'm okay with that. Martin Gonzalez, I think, gives us a good defensive middle infielder next season because we're not going to bring back Nicky Lopez. So I think Gonzalez fills that role. Right. So I'm going to wait and see what we get on Lofton before I make the deal. So let's go ahead and finish the day. All right. Our scouts are even higher on him. That control actually went up. So let's go ahead and make this deal. We're going to send Robert Hassel to the Texas Rangers, in along with minor leaguers Josh Alger, Ethan Hott, Noah Malone, and veteran Yoan Moncada, who's been in AAA. And in exchange, we're going to get Bradley Lofton, Joey Cantillo, and Martin Gonzalez. Gonzalez will help us next year. Cantillo will be minor league pitching depth, and Lofton will likely slot right into our starting lineup or starting rotation. So we make the deal. They don't like the fact that we gave up Lofton. They like the fact that we picked up, or they don't like the fact that we gave up Hassel. Like the fact that we brought in Lofton. Fan interest is sitting at an 80. All right. So from a pitching perspective, Woodward can go back down, and we will immediately call up Lofton, stick him in the rotation, and he's a lefty, which I like as well. And then we have to call one other. So Cantillo's gonna. Oh, he's gotta go on the 40-man. Fine. Put him on the 40-man. Put him in AAA. He has to clear waivers. Okay. Well, that's a thing. Holy crap! Sims signed. I did not anticipate that happening. They all signed. That's crazy. I didn't think that was gonna happen. All right. Well, that works. We gotta go to the DSL, I think, to find Gonzalez. Put him in AAA. And so who else can go down? So I think Jansen goes back down. And we will call up Cantillo. Make him a long reliever. And then lineup-wise, McDaniel goes in left field. McDaniel goes in left field. And Royce Lewis moves into the leadoff spot. We will move some people around here. I think we go with something like that. Something like this. And that will work. All right. So our backup left fielder is now Crow Armstrong. Now Crow Armstrong. And we got to call one other player up. I don't think it matters from a positional standpoint. Let's call up Taj. Ty Pete. No, let's call up Arrow Vera. Let's call up Vera. He's got a bit better bat. All right. I think that's gonna be it for trades here in July. Pick up a couple of pitchers, move out another contract. We lose two in a row to a bad Austin team. We win that one 5-2. Couple of hits for Cruz, couple of hits for McDaniel. Baz improves to 9-7. Now we have a 5-game series at home against the Mets. 6-3 loss. There's Romo and Nebe, and now Lofton is hurt. Are you kidding? Okay. Well, that such is life. So he'll go down. Romo will come up. We'll see what the answer is on Lofton, but Nebe will go on a rehab assignment for the time being. Romo will come back into the lineup. We'll do that. Susak, and when he's tired, Romo will play, or he'll play when Romo is tired. All right, so we've lost three out of four here. Hopefully, Lofton isn't out too long. We win 6-2. Two hits from Lewis, Robert, Dylan Cruz with his 32nd home run of the year, Crane with his 33rd. Chase Shores goes 4 1/3. Joey Cantillo picks up his first win. Any note? Nope, no note yet on Lofton. Is he still just pending? Yep. All right, we got a doubleheader today against the Mets. Win one, lose one. We lose Lofton for 4 to 5 weeks, and Nebe is hurt again. Back spasms. Good stuff. All right, so we win one, lose one. Who got the start in this? Ooh, Corbin Burns gets. Oh, he only gave up 3 5 1/3. And then we win the second game 3-2. Estes pitches well again. The bullpen locks it down. 14 games up. We gotta call a pitcher up. And we'll call Nebe back up and we'll just tell the game to. Oh, God, no, we can't. Every one of our pitchers is tired. We gotta call up somebody who can start today. I guess we call up Jansen. I just rested. All right. I got Jansen going today. Hopefully that'll help. Hopefully we can go long enough into the game to help our bullpen a little bit. Yeah, what I was not hoping for was an extra inning game. So Jansen did what we needed him to do. He went 7 1/3 innings, but the bullpen was not good. So now we got Chicago. We're 68-42. We are essentially a 500 team this month. We got 2 games left. 13-11 in July. 14-11 in July. Dylan Cruz 2-for-3 with a couple of RBIs. He hits 2 home runs. Shane Baz is 10-7 now on the year. Twins trade offer expired. That's fine. All right. Where is Nebe? Is he still? Yeah, he's still down. Back spasms for 3 days. We'll call him up in 3 days, I think. Who's pitching today? We get a day off here, so at least we'll be able to rest up the bullpen here in a couple of days. I think we're good. I think we just sim through the final day of the month. See if we can pick up our 70th win of the year at the end of July. Nope. 69-43. Nice to end the month. So McDaniel moves into the starter role. How's he done lately? He's had some hits. Not hitting for a lot of power, but I think that will come. Lofton gets better, but he's out for 4 weeks. We'll get him back September. Mullinax drops a little. Yeah, not much going on. Shane Baz is the pitcher of the month in the National League. 10-7, 3-4-1. We got all of these guys who signed. That's huge. I was not anticipating that. Bergen's going to start there. Atienzo's going to start there. Carr's going to start here. And I think we'll call him up. We'll call Barnett up because he's 22. Let's do this. Bland is hurt. That's no good. Diagnosis pending. Not really hitting in AAA. Where's my guy? Is he hurt? Barclay's shoulder bursitis. Not really hitting, but I still, worst case scenario, he is a pretty good utility guy, but we'll see how it goes. All right, so we're 69-43. We are 12 and a half games up on the Mets, 13 games up on the Braves. From a Major League Baseball perspective, we have the best record in baseball, second best record in baseball behind the Mariners. 4-6 in our last 10, not great. Second best offense, sixth best pitching staff, suffering for dealing with some injuries. We'll get Lofton back in a month. Hopefully, these guys can hold the fort down until then. Dylan Cruz on pace for almost 50 home runs. Same thing with Davis Crane. Juan Villalobos on pace for 40-100 in his first season with the Nationals, making the league minimum. You'll love to see that. CJ Abrams wants $24 million a year for 7 years. I'm not prepared to give him that. I would probably give him, how old is he? 28? He's 28. I would probably give him 5 at 20. Roughly, if he can stay healthy the rest of this season and play 135 games, I mean, if he can play 130 games, put up 4 WAR, I'm fine with 5 at 20, but we will see what happens. So it's gonna do it, guys. Let me know what you think of our draft. Let me know what you think. If did I outsmart myself with that trade? Like, we put Royce Lewis in the leadoff spot. He's hitting 300 now. So moving on from Hassel means we don't necessarily now have to decline the option on Royce Lewis. We can still sign Abrams. That's really the only major contract that we have up. We could bring back Wandison Charles, but he probably wants a lot. Well, it's not actually not terrible. We could probably figure out a way to make both of those work, especially if we move on from Munoz. I'm not likely to pay him $8 million next year. So, or Crow Armstrong 6.8. So that's nearly $15 million. We can go from right there. So that's gonna do it, guys. So yeah, let me know your thoughts. As always, I appreciate your support. I appreciate you guys watching. Talk to everybody soon. Bye.